In this video, I'd like to talk to you about the architecture of layered channels, and I'll start with how we leverage the single channel architecture in order to layer multiple channels and create Meru's multi-channel architecture. Before getting into the details of what we do and what the benefits are, I'd like to step back and start with how the legacy microcell approach works. Now, the fundamental principle in providing coverage in any area is the following. You have access points that transmit, and signal decays over distance, right? So here is a transmitter. On the y-axis is signal strength, and on the x-axis is distance. As you go further away, signal strength decays. So you want to make sure that access points are not placed so far away, right, that there is a coverage hole. I hope you get the point. But at the same time, access points on the same channel can't be placed so close together that there is actually an overlap. So let's look at this in terms of circles. And I'm going to retain this picture because we'll come to this in a little bit. So the idea is you have one access point. On the same channel, the legacy microcell architecture requires that you don't place access points so far away that there is a coverage gap. But if you place access points very close together, then in fact there'll be co-channel interference. And the whole point of a microcell architecture is to eliminate co-channel interference by design. In a companion video, we'll talk about how difficult that is to achieve in practice. But for the moment, let's kind of go along with that. And therefore, if you want to create a channel plan, here is what you would do, right? So you would take multiple colors, channels, and you would create for yourself a channel plan. So notice that you need at least three colors, even in a simple two-dimensional picture. And obviously, the world is three-dimensional, and coverage is not nice circles. So there are, you know, inherent limitations with the microcell architecture from that perspective, or indeed any channel planning architecture. But even assuming perfection and a two-dimensional world, here's where you are, right? So you have access points. In this particular case, all the blues are on one channel, all the oranges are on another channel, and all the reds are on a third channel. So notice here that you actually needed, and I'll shade it here so you can actually see it more clearly. So notice here that you actually need multiple colors just in order to get essentially one layer of coverage. So what do I mean by one layer? At any one point, there's exactly one channel that offers you coverage. And now in the 2.4 gigahertz range, you have only three channels, 1, 6, and 11, that are non-overlapping. Therefore, if you want to provide a coverage in 2.4 gigahertz channel, you are essentially using up all your channels, all the available channel capacity, just to provide one layer of coverage. Now, in the 5 gigahertz band, you have a lot more channels. However, once you start doing 40 megahertz, larger 802.11n channel plans, the number of channels comes down dramatically. And further, in a three-dimensional network, you actually need more channels. So fundamentally, with a microcell approach, you get one layer worth. And you're going to use pretty much all the available channels in order to create this one layer worth of coverage. So what we have done, as you've seen from companion videos, is let me leave this here because I want to still talk about this. What we've done is created the ability wherein you take your neighboring access points and put all of them on the same channel. Now remember that this, combined with all of these access points advertising the same BSS ID, effectively gives you one layer wherein, from a client perspective, it's always connected to its own single virtual port. More on that in a companion video. But the point here is, taking like for like, using a single color, because we do not require co-channel interference mitigation by design, we are able to take multiple access points, put them on the same channel, coordinate across all of these access points, and provide you coverage. Now, if you know how to paint the floor with a single channel, you can paint the floor with all channels. So in fact, you could do the same thing with the orange. And you could do the same thing with red, right? So like for like, you have the ability to get 3 channels worth of coverage in any given location. And obviously, as you go to 5 gigahertz, you have more channels available. Therefore, we are not constrained in this architecture by either the geography or the fact that these need to be nice two-dimensional circles. Because we only care about providing coverage, we handle co-channel interference mitigation as a part of the core value of the architecture. And this is something unique to us. It's patent-pending technology. And that's sort of what causes us to essentially layer multiple channels. Why would you want to layer multiple channels? Well, there are several reasons. So think of it as follows. You take a building and you provide broad coverage with one channel. But maybe there are areas of high density. In campus buildings, it might be classrooms, it might be libraries, it might be conference rooms. So there you want to add more and more capacity. As you add capacity, you can start layering channels. And mind you, as a part of our core Meru architecture, you're not required to pervasively layer channels. You start with a single channel coverage, and then you can layer to taste. You can start layering more and more channels as and when you need them. You might want to do this for capacity. You might want to do this for additional spectral redundancy. We already have redundancy built in because access points overlap and they transmit at peak power. So within a single channel, we have redundancy built in. But in addition to single channel redundancy, you can also create for yourself a multi-channel, spectrally redundant architecture. And this is something that is completely unique to Meru. In any given location, you have the ability to paint that floor with multiple channels so that if there ever is a problem here, clients can instantaneously jump over to neighboring channels. This works very well in areas where there is very high RF contention, where in fact just screwing around with trying to adjust the coverage plans and power just doesn't cut it. So this offers a way wherein the network or the infrastructure by design provides redundant coverage across multiple channels. And of course, if all the channels are available, then you get higher capacity. Once you do that, you can also think of other interesting ways of using this. You can use this in order to put, maybe some of your devices in this particular channel, and use other devices or SSIDs, or going back to a companion video on policies, to other channels. So you can actually map on a policy basis, you can map users or applications to individual channels. You might also have a legacy ABG network, and you might want to migrate to a 11N network. Of course, as a part of our inherent architecture, 11N access points interoperate with ABG access points on the same channel. But if you want to spectrally separate them in order to maximize 11N efficiency, you could do this. Please don't misunderstand, you can place 11N and ABG access points on the same channel. However, if you want to make sure that you quarantine all your legacy devices to one channel and maximize application or 11N benefits on a separate channel, this architecture allows you the benefit or the ability to do that, which an architecture like this doesn't. One further benefit, in addition to all this, if you're thinking about doing a gradual migration from a legacy architecture or a legacy vendor to Meru, this also allows you a very nice way of doing this. Now, of course, don't misunderstand again, Meru networks will work, or access points will work, in a totally fair and standards compliant manner with other vendors' access points or any standards compliant vendor's access point on the same channel. However, there is a very easy way to overcome the burden of doing complex network planning with having multi-vendors coexisting. In order to do that, what you could do is take one channel, put Meru on it, and let the other vendors use their channels in order to mess around with the microcell architecture. So the idea is not that we force our customers or we require our customers to go the layered channel approach for any of the benefits we've talked about in terms of redundancy or capacity or coordination or switch-like behavior, but that this layering allows the customer to selectively, in areas of interest, provide additional redundancy or capacity or the ability to, you know, separate traffic or users or introduce new technologies like LAN. Thank you.